This photovoltaic solar cooker can be used to cook all types of food in boiling water at 100 degrees Celsius. Vegetables, rice, pasta, potatoes, sauces and braising. The solar cooker is simple. No battery, no regulation, no power electronics. It's directly connected to the photovoltaic panel, so that you can cook indoor without smoke, of course. There is a structure made of plywood, but any other material could be suitable. A control panel with manual switches and with a small wattmeter to help the user. A heating block made of an aluminium sheet under which several small PTC ceramic heaters are. There is, of course, a cooking pot and an integral insulation made of plywood and towels. The PTC are the masterpiece of the cooker. Their flexibility adapts very well to the variation of the energy supplied by the photovoltaic panels. These heaters self-regulate. They won't go beyond 220 degrees Celsius. This is amazing because, one, they cannot be destroyed by burnout like conventional resistors. Two, you can insulate the firing pot with ordinary cotton textile. That is an advantage because the max temperature of the ceramics is not hot enough to set the cotton textile on fire, but it's just enough to boil water. You place the pot or a pressure cooker on the hot plate. You install the thermal insulation. The insulation is the key of the cooker to the cooker's performance. Then you turn switches and you look at the wattmeter to see which combination gives you the most power. That is the optimum working condition for the solar cooker according to the weather you have right now. And that's it. Nothing more to do. If big clouds show up, don't worry. Your food will still be cooked thanks to the great insulation. And if you want to optimize the power of your solar cooker, you can do it. Just change the switch combination and it will adapt to the new weather. A liter of water at room temperature is boiled in 35 minutes. That is with a 280 panel and solar radiation of 950 watts per square meter. You can proceed to several cooking sessions in a day if the panel is mobile. With one solar panel, you can cook with two solar cookers at once. While one cooker heats up, the other keeps on cooking just like a Norwegian pot. How to improve this performance? To cook at night, you can heat erythritol with a solar panel in the day, which allows you to store enough energy to cook at night. And if you want more powerful cooker, just add photovoltaic panels. The cooker has no size limits. A PTC ceramic heater costs 1 euro. The watt meter costs less than 10 euros. A switch costs around 5 euros. Be careful to buy a well-made switch so it can handle the intensity of the direct current. The price of photovoltaic panels is constantly decreasing. Today, a solar panel with 350 watts can cost about 130 euros. In addition to cooking, you can use a ceramic heater system for domestic hot water production, to heat swimming pool, and for inter-seasonal heat storage. Solar energy storage via hot water does not require any additional device such as a battery or a controller. To optimize the energy production of the solar panel, you can use a microcontroller such as an Arduino. An Arduino automatically adjusts the number of heaters according to the sensor. Keep in mind that it is a very light electronic control, bearing no comparison with the usual power electronics in photovoltaic solar energy. The solar cooker is designed to be handmade close to its use location. It's made to be easy to make and easy to use. Moreover, photovoltaic panels do not contain rare metals, so the photovoltaic solar cooker can contribute to sustainable energy production and wide access to everyday energy. The solar cooker with PTC ceramic heater reaches an incompressible level of simplicity. All the documentation concerning the cooker and the instructions for its construction are available on the website photovoltaicsolarcooking.org. And thank you for your attention.